Hello everyone, welcome to Design Goridham. I am Shelly. In order to work efficiently and effortlessly on your devices, a file system is required by most of the applications you come in contact with. There are numerous file systems in use. For example, Windows uses FAT32 or XFAT and NTFS, while Macs use FAT32, XFAT, HFS Plus and APFS. Although NTFS is more advanced than FAT32, it cannot replace FAT32 totally. FAT32 as a traditional file system is compatible with many external mediums. So some users would like to reformat to FAT32 from NTFS sometimes for other purposes. Let's see why and when it is required to change the file system and how to do it correctly. I am having an external hard disk. I have already partitioned it. If you do not know how to partition a storage device, you can watch the video that I have made on this topic. Link is given in the card above and in the description below. Now, as you can see, if I right click on any of these partitions and go into the format, it is displaying that the current file system is NTFS. Now let's check if my iPad is able to read this file system or not. This is my iPad Air 4 2020 edition, and I am going to use an OTG that I got with my Google Pixel phone to connect my hard drive with my iPad. Can you see this light on the hard disk? It shows that it has started. Now let's see if we can open it in files on iPad. So I can see all the partitions on my hard disk. Right now the hard disk is empty. Let's try to copy something from my iPad to this drive. So you can see I can't do that. This option isn't available. It means I have to change the file system on the hard disk into one that is readable by my iPad. I will plug my hard disk again to my laptop. I will right click on one of these partitions and choose format. A window will pop up. Here you have to choose XFAT. You can label the volume as well. In my case, I want it to be general. Now hit the start button. A warning will pop up that says all data on this disk will be erased. So you have to be careful while formatting the disk. If you have any important data or files saved on this partition, you should first take a backup of that on your PC or some other storage device. Once you have done that, you are good to go. You can format your disk safely. You have to click OK in this warning window. The disk will be formatted to XFAT file system. Let's check if it is working on the iPad now or not. So I am plugging it into my iPad and will go into the files. I am going to copy the same file from my iPad to the hard disk again that I was trying to copy before. And you can see I can now copy it on my hard disk. Let's check on the laptop if the file is opening properly or not. So it is working. I hope this video will help you to make your hard disk work with your iPad now. And if it really helps you, you can hit the like button and tell me in the comment section. And do subscribe to my channel for more stuff like this. And you can also hit the bell icon so that you won't miss any notifications about my upcoming videos. Thanks a lot.